Hala Diyab is a Syrian activist, a filmmaker, and a TV personality. She's also a spokeswoman for the UK-based Organization for Democracy and Freedom in Syria, and she joins me now from London. Hala, thanks for being with us. What are your thoughts about a potential strike against Syria coming from Western countries as a direct response to that alleged chemical attack?
Before any military intervention has to be taken in Syria, there should be legitimate reasons and there should be investigation whether this chemical weapon has been used by the regime and who really used them, and to punish and bring these people who use this chemical weapon by international court. And also we need to identify the objective of this military intervention. Is it actually to punish Assad for using the chemical weapon, or is it to get rid of Assad? If it is to punish Assad for using the chemical weapon, we have a history in the Middle East where punishing a dictator who used a mass weapons like Saddam, who used chemical weapon on his people, or even Bin Laden. By killing Bin Laden, we didn't kill the ideology of terrorism and the ideology of Al-Qaeda. That shows the futility of using violence in order to deter violence and stop violence.
But so let me ask you, what do you think the response should be?
I think there should be international condemnation of what happened. There should be a thorough investigation of who used the chemical weapon, whether it's the regime, whether it's the rebel or third party, and who owns this chemical weapon, and bring them to international court, stressing diplomacy and political solution in order to get rid of Assad regime, because now Assad is an illegitimate leader who is causing destruction to Syria, inside Syria and for outside the Syrian people. And I think that many politicians forget about Syrian people, the common people, the mothers, the children, who actually are paying and will pay the price for any military
intervention. So you don't think anything would justify the use of force in the case of Bashar al-Assad in Syria? You think it should only be condemnation and then bringing those leaders to the International Criminal Court? Nothing would justify the use of force, in your opinion?
Force to get rid of Bashar, force to dismantle the regime of a dictator who is legitimizing violence against his people. And if you look at the Syrian revolution since the start, Syrian revolution has been hijacked by the Syrian people who went to the streets by in order to move from a peaceful demonstration into sectarian war and now into international war. The problem is the Middle East now is like a Pandora box, and any more militarizing of the crisis can lead to more bloodshed, to more escalation of the problem with the vulnerability of the border.
But what's the solution? I mean, it seems intractable. Sorry to jump in. Here you have on one side, you have a regime with a military, with strikes from the air, with possibly, as we're learning now, also chemical attacks being used. And on the other hand, as you said, a rebel force that uses conventional weapons, and some of them are Free Syrian Army, others are more extremist radicals. How do you solve the Syrian tragedy? How do you do
it? You should solve it not by adding more strikes on Syria and maybe destroy what is left for Syrian people. There should be more work. I mean, in 2 days, the whole international community come together in order to find possibilities to do the military intervention. For 2 years, why the international community didn't come together in order to oblige Assad to leave and to form political decent political opposition that can really fill up the vacuum in Syria. And now we can see the frosty attitude of the Russian government has changed now, because they know about the chemical weapon. And I think there is a chance now for more talk with Russia in order to oblige the Syrian regime to find a political solution and to come to negotiation.
So, Hala, what you're saying is essentially once the red line, quote, unquote, of chemical weapons was crossed, for 2 days the entire West came together to discuss a solution. However, in 2+ years of a real crisis unfolding, that effort was not made, and it should be made to find a diplomatic exit. Is that what you're saying, essentially?
Yes, and we need to define what is the red line. Having 200,000 dead people in Syria is not a red line. 1.7 refugees is not a red line. 7.6 displaced Syrian is not a red line. Young people who has been jailed in detentions in Assad regime just being in the demonstration is not a red line. I think there is here a kind of duality from the international community of defining moral responsibility of international community and the responsibility of politicians to act because they don't want to be blamed by not acting.
All right. Hala Diyab, thanks very much for joining us from London there with your take. A very interesting conversation. Thanks again for your time here on CNN.